journey of stakeholder. First of all, who is stakeholder? Stakeholder is anyone who is being affected by the project or who perceive that the project can affect him. So anyone who perceive or anyone whom the project is really affecting. So for example, if we are making a dam, a hydro dam, all the people that will be affected because of the water, that will, the level of the rise of the water will be there, the water that will come from all the people living near that area are stakeholders. Even our shopkeeper, even the DCO, even the government officers, all people are stakeholders. So you need to identify stakeholders. This is a step one and most important step. Identify the stakeholders. Now, how to identify the stakeholders? There are various ways. You can use OPS, organizational process assets. You have lesson learned document here. You have organogram there, project organizational chart there, company's policies, procedures, and the most important, of course, lesson learned repository. Then we also have EEF, enterprise environmental factor. Who are the internal stakeholder, external stakeholder, government bodies, all those things, who comes under enterprise environmental factor. You also use PESTEL for risk and stakeholder also. Who are the political stakeholder, environmental stakeholder, social, technological, legal, and economical stakeholders. Also, VUCA is there, volatile, uncertain, complex. So you use a list to identify stakeholder. You use all the documents, project charter, project management plan, project documents, business case, benefit management plan, agreements. In summary, whatever is available, we need to get a comprehensive list of all stakeholders. Very important. Get the list of all stakeholders. This is step number one. And then put all the stakeholders into a stakeholder register. Put all the stakeholders into stakeholder register. Once you have put all the stakeholders in the stakeholder register, good. It can be 10 or it can be 10,000, depending upon how good you did. So I would prefer 10,000 as compared to 10. If you have identified only 10, I don't think so, you have done a good job. Okay, once you have identified, the next job is classify them, prioritize them. So classify the stakeholder as who are the upward stakeholder. Upward means whom you report. Whom you report, like you have to report to your boss, he's an upward stakeholder. Who are downward stakeholder? Who are reporting to you? Who are your sideways stakeholder? Your peers, the people who are working with you, your peers, the other project managers. And maybe all of them are internal stakeholder. We also need to identify the external stakeholders. Who are external stakeholders? Once we have done this, we have identified, now we need to represent them using power interest matrix. Who stakeholder have more power? Which stakeholders have more interest? Let's say here we get more power, more interest. Here we will have less power, more interest. More power, less interest. Less power, less interest. So who are the stakeholders who come under high power, high interest? The stakeholders who are very interested in the project. Maybe your sponsor, product owner, team, etc. Who are the stakeholders have high power but no interest? Maybe your CEOs of the company, maybe MD, if they don't think your project is that important. If your project is very important for them, then they becomes the high power, high interest. Government agencies, the government officials, most of the time they don't care whatever you are doing. It is all over the world. If you're making a car, so they don't care that which car you are making, which mobile phone you are making. So they have high power, but they have no interest, but they have high power. Then people having low power but high interest, your competitors. Your competitors can come here. Other peers who have no, like other project managers, all those people come here. Media, if you are doing a government project, maybe media, or you are doing an either the iPhone, supercar, they can come here. People who have no power and no interest, mostly kitchen staff, security guards, other people, that, like, if we take an example of security guards and kitchen, they are more in favor of when we get promotion. They don't care what really the project is going on. If you are working in a company, what is happening in the company? Even if you are making an electric car or a combustion engine, a normal car, they don't care. They have no power and they have no interest in that. No power, no interest. Kitchen staff, I then put it, kitchen staff. Okay, now comes the, you have classified them. Now comes the how to manage them. The engagement strategies in order to see how to manage them. Here, this is the most important, you manage them closely. You talk to them, you communicate them, you provide the information, you keep on communicating them, collaborating them, seeing if they are virtual, how to use Kanban board, how to see other things. Collaboration, more collaboration with them, making sure that you make them satisfied, they are happy with you, and they are with you in the project all the way. Then here you need to keep them satisfied. People having high power, low interest, they don't need your daily report. They need your daily report, weekly report, monthly. They may even ask, okay, give us annual report. Shareholders, we will see at the annual report. So here, whatever you do, you need to satisfy them. Here, PMI says that keep them informed. If you don't want to give right information, maybe sometimes you even need to give the false information depending upon your company's strategies. Or you can give them second-hand information, or you can even give the right information. The iPhone is launching, give them information, keep them informed, so you can create a hype. Whatever you do, you need to keep them informed. And here, this is a very interesting area. You need to push them in the watch list. You need to put them into the watch list, because it is possible along the way, any one of them, power got increased, their interest increases, so you need to periodically review them, what they are doing, what is happening with them. This is a very important thing. And also, someone can become arsenal between them. They can call a strike and all those things. So we must have a strategy also that. Once you have done this, and next thing come to see what is their current engagement and what is our desired engagement. So we make stakeholder engagement matrix. So name, unaware, resistant, neutral, supporting, leading. So we need to identify that among these stakeholders, who is unaware of us, who is not aware that we are doing something. Let's say if as I am a PMP trainer, I want more and more students come and join my batch program and my mentor program. But if you are unaware of me, you don't know me, how you can join. For that, I make promotional videos and so many things that we do so that the people become more aware of us. If you are aware of us, that we can work on. So let's say your current engagement level is this, and I want you to be supportive of my program, to join my program. This is a desired stage. This is a desired stage. And we make stakeholder engagement plan. We make stakeholder engagement plan to change the current engagement state into desired engagement state. Stakeholder engagement plan is nothing but a plan that will have strategies. Strategies how to change the current engagement level of a stakeholder to your desired engagement level. Current engagement to desired. And throughout the project life cycle, throughout the various process groups, the current engagement and desired engagement level, it varies, it gets changed, things get modified, things get updated. So maybe a stakeholder is currently resistant to you. You don't want him right now to be supportive, but changing his strategy to a neutral can work for you. So changing current to the desired. We make a stakeholder engagement plan about all the strategies. So we look at this matrix, we look at this chart, and we make sure that the stakeholders are satisfied. We implement that plan and manage stakeholder engagement, and throughout the process we are monitoring. Monitoring is all about checking what was the plan, what stakeholder engagement plan we have made, is it valid or not, is it working or not. If a new stakeholder is identified, how we are gonna do, we check its actual and plan. So these are the things about stakeholder engagement. A very important thing, apart from power interest matrix, we can also use salience model. Power, interest, and urgency. Power, legitimacy, and urgency. So exam can ask you about salience model. Salience model is a 3D model having three domains. We can also make power interest as a 3D model and can have that third domain as attitude, whatever, geography, and this becomes as a stakeholder queue. So we have three grids: power interest, salience model, power urgency legitimacy, stakeholder queue, power interest, attitude or geography, depending upon the scenarios. And we make this thing, very important thing, anytime a new stakeholder is identified, we go to step number one, we put the stakeholder into stakeholder register, we check his power interest, where he stands, we check his current engagement, desired engagement level, and we see, does our stakeholder engagement plans need update, if change is required, if stakeholder need an update, then we change that and we update that plan and we work in according this. Guys, stakeholder engagement plan or stakeholder journey of stakeholder is one of the most important journey. Agile communication, stakeholder resource, or also known as team now, is the most important part of your exam. Straightforward, 42% of the questions will come from here. But according to the feedback we have received from certified PMP, now we have 131 certified PMP in 2021. We know that this covered more than 67% of the real exam. So very, very important. If you have any question about this topic, comment me, or you can contact me my number or at my email address, and I will make sure that I answer your queries. And if you want to do PMP training, we are going to start a new batch on 10th of September, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 2 weeks in September. Currently, batch number 11 is in progress. Already two students of batch 10 have certified. That's how our batch program works. You enroll in it and in 1 month you become certified. So if you want to join, you can join batch program, or if you want to learn at your own pace, you can join our one-to-one program, or that is also known as mentor program. So you can contact us and we will make sure you become certified PMP. Thank you very much for watching, and become a certified PMP. Thank you.